Hello everyone, this is Raghav, SMA at the GATE Academy. In this video, we'll solve a question from Theory of Machines, a previous GATE question. This was asked in GATE 2004. It was asked for 2 marks. It's a very good GATE question for locating instantaneous center of rotation for 2 links. So the question, you can see on the board, the question is like this. The figure below shows a planar mechanism with single degree of freedom. The instantaneous center I24 for the given configuration is located at a position. So he gave the diagram in the question. You can see the diagram in the question. He is saying that where does common instantaneous center of rotation for links 2 and 4 lie? It lies at, options are given, L, or it lies at M, or it lies at N, or it lies at infinite. Okay, so this is what the question is. So if you look at the diagram, so the mechanism is given something like this. So this is link 1 and this is link 2 and this is saying it as link 3 and this is link 4 and this is again a fixed link, this is link 1. So he is asking us to look at the instantaneous center of rotation, common instantaneous center of rotation for links 2 and 4. So whenever you want to locate instantaneous centers of rotation, first you need to know how to locate some basic instantaneous centers. Now I am trying to locate the basic instantaneous centers inside this mechanism. If you look at links 1 and 2, the relative motion between links 1 and 2 is sliding. So for sliding motion, for pure sliding, it's pure translation. The I center lies at infinite in the direction perpendicular to plane of sliding. So I center, the relative I center for links 1 and 2 will lie at infinite in the direction perpendicular to plane of sliding. So I12 is at infinite in the direction perpendicular to the plane of sliding. Now you can see 2 and 3, links 2 and links 3 are connected by a turning pair here. Since these two links are connected by a turning pair here, so I23 will lie so at this hinge. Whenever two links are connected by a turning pair, the common instantaneous center will lie at the hinge. This is link 3 and this is link 4. 3 and 4 are connected by a turning pair here, so I34 will lie here. You can see the relative motion between 1 and 4. The relative motion between 1 and 4 is sliding. Therefore, the common instantaneous center of rotation for links 1-4, that is I-1-4, will lie at infinite in the direction perpendicular to the plane of sliding. Plane of sliding is vertical, so it lies at infinite in the direction perpendicular to its plane. So these are some basic instantaneous centers we have located. So to locate the remaining instantaneous centers, you draw a polygon having number of sides equal to number of links. So here there are 4 links inside the mechanism. I am drawing a polygon having 4 sides. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4. You can see the mechanism. I12 is already located, I23 is located, I34 is located, I14 is located. And what is not located is, so I13 is not located. So to locate I13, I say like this. So I can go from 1, 2, 3 like this. So draw a line passing through 1, 2, 2 and 2, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 2 and 2, 2, 3. Or draw a line passing through 1, 2, 4 and 3, 2, 4. So 1, 4. Or 4-3. We have already located I12, I23. So draw a line passing through I12, 2-3. If you look at this line is already passing through I12 and I23. And similarly, draw a line passing through I14 and I34. So I14, 3-4, this line is already passing through I14, 3-4. Wherever these two lines intersect, so that gives you I13. And similarly, so I24 is also not located, and the question is about I24. So I can go from 2 to 4 like this. I can go from 2 to 4 like this. So draw a line passing through 2, draw a line passing from, I can go from 2 to 4 like this, 2 to 3 and 3 to 4. So 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Or I can say, so 2 to 1 and 1 to 4. So 2, 1, 1, 4. So I can say like this, I24 lies on line joining 2, 3, 3, 4, or it lies on line joining 1, 2, 1, 4. There's no difference between 2, 1 or 1, 2. It's a common instantaneous center for links 1 and 2, that's it. So draw a line passing through 2, 3 and 3, 4. This is 2, 3 and this is 3, 4. So I am drawing a line passing through 2, 3 and 3, 4. So I am drawing a line passing through 2, 3 and 3, 4. This line passes through 2, 3 and 3, 4. And similarly, so draw a line passing through 1, 2 and 1, 4. If you look at this I12 is at infinite and I14 is also at infinite. So if I draw a line passing through these two points, I12 and I14, so this line, since these two points are at infinite, I say like this, this line also lies at infinite. So I14 is at infinite in this direction 1, 2 is at infinite in this direction. If I draw a line passing through these two isenters, so it lies at infinite. But because these two points are at infinite, the line also lies at infinite. So one line is here and the other line is at infinite. And I can say like this, these two lines will intersect at infinite. Are you getting my point? So you know the location of this line. This line is here. But the other line, if you want to see the other line, you need to go to infinite. And if I see the if I want to see the intersection of those two lines, so I need to go to infinite. Why? Because you can see the other line. So when you go to infinite, and I can say that at infinite, the intersection is going to happen. That's what the meaning. So the instantaneous center of rotation, without these two lines intersect, there I24 lies. Since this line is at infinite, I say the intersection will also happen at infinite. So I24 will lie at infinite. I13 will lie here. Okay. So it's nothing but it's the common instantaneous center for links 2 and 4. Where should I stand on link 2 or link 4 so that I can see the relative motion between these two links as pure rotation? This link is moving along a straight line and that link also moving along a straight line. You can't see the relative motion between these two links to be in pure rotation unless you stand at infinite. If you stand at infinite, then you can see the relative motion. I mean, then you can see a translating motion to be a pure rotation. Because every straight line is a part of circle with infinite radius. Then if you stand at infinite, you can see one sliding motion as a rotary motion or as a pure rotation. Thank you.